guys, it's Auntie Princess Santa here.
What's an embryo?
Embryo? Maybe the embryo is like part of the muscles. So an embryo tells the germs like anything, and then the germs tell the muscles like when to move, probably.
What's a recessive gene?
Recessive gene? Well, I know the genes tell the body when to move, right? And I think the genes know when you have to be born, probably. And what kind of DNA you should have, probably. And what kind of body or skin color you should have, and what kind of eye color you should have, probably.
What's meningitis?
Meningitis? The meningitis. I think that would be part of the bones. So it's like part of the leg bones, probably. So I think the meningitis is part. I think the heels are, like, have bones in them, too. I think the meningitis is part of the heel bones.
What is angina?
Angina? Angina. That might be part of the intestines, maybe. So it's, like, the part where the small intestine connects to the large intestine, probably.
What is thrombosis?
Thrombosis? Thrombosis. Thrombosis in the body? Thrombosis. Well, my guess for the thrombosis is probably part of the kneecap. So the thrombosis like in the kneecap, so it knows when the kneecap has to move.
How does your hair grow?
How does my hair grow? Well, it grows when you get older. So it's like, one, you have bold hair. Two, you have the same kind of hair when you were one. And then three, you start growing some hair. And then four, you grow more hair. I think it's part of the genes, so the genes tell when the hair has to start growing, probably.
Interesting. How does your stomach work?
How does my stomach work? Well, I think that's how it digests the food and makes it into teeny tiny little pieces before sending to the small intestine, probably. I think that's what the stomach does.
Where does it go from the small intestine to where?
Of the large intestine.
What are your tonsils?
Tonsils? I think tonsils is a longer word for teeth.
How does your eardrum hear sound?
Well, there's two different kinds of ways that your eardrums can hear sound. One of them is like when it goes in through one ear and then comes out the other ear. When you hear sound. And the other is when it goes into one ear and goes into the other ear.
So the sound either goes in one ear and out the other ear, or when in one ear and into the other ear.
Yeah.
What's the difference? How do you know when it happens?
Well, one of the differences, the difference between them is when it goes in through one ear and comes out the other ear is when, like, you're reading something and, like, say, you were reading something and you were snuggling a stuffy, me or something. And then, actually, I was talking and you were still reading the comment, the longest comment, and then you heard it for 1 minute and then you didn't hear it again. So then you were like, what? And then the other one is when it comes in one ear and comes in the other ear, is when you're not reaching or not snuggling anybody, and you're actually having a conversation with somebody. Yeah.
Okay, got it.
That's a difference.
That makes sense.
That is just for examples.
Mm-hmm. That makes a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. What is all the way up your nose?
I don't know. Maybe that goes into the eyes.
So if you stick your finger all the way up your nose, you can poke your eyeball?
Maybe. Hmm. Like, if you, like, stick it up and then turn it?
Yeah.
Probably? Yeah.
Poke yourself in the eyeball?
Yeah, like the back of it.
What's behind your eyeballs?
Muscles.
Oh. Yeah?
So you would probably, like, poke the muscles. And I think there's fluid that goes around the eyes, too.
What's all the way at the back of your throat?
All the way at the back of the throat? Well, back of the throat. I don't know. Because I think it's just like a regular tube that goes down into the esophagus. And then it goes into the stomach and then to the intestines.
Do you want to be a doctor when you grow up?
Yeah.
Why?
I also want to be a vet.
And a vet?
Yeah.
Why?
And I want to be a unicorn.
Okay.
And a tiny rabbit, and a cat, and a giraffe.
You want to be a giraffe when you grow up?
Yes.
How do you propose you're going to become a giraffe?
Because giraffe cracker?
You're going to eat a giraffe cracker?
Yeah, and it'll turn me into a giraffe.
But why do you want to be a doctor?
Well, I want to be a vet and a regular doctor because then I can see what's in the human body of mine or what's in the human body of other people's.
You want to look inside other people's bodies.
Yeah. That's why.
All right. I think that's all the questions we have for tonight.
Okay.
Thank you for answering my questions.
You're welcome. Bye-bye, everybody. Thank you. Bye.